on it will sport chart.
How am I going to know about all this that you're doing?
Because it cannot leave the account without your signature.
I don't know what you're doing.
No, do you understand that?
I don't have to
prove it. You get a statement.
No one can take anything out.
You have a statement every month. Nobody can take any money out unless you have to sign for it.
It's in your control.
Sounds like the usual.
All right.
Sounds like the unusual.
Here, shake on it. There you have it.
Yeah. Okay. Well, Columbus took a chance.
On what?
Lindbergh took a chance. Have faith.
Faith on nothing.
Bill, man, you can't go out like that.
Got to be upbeat.
Yeah. I mean, you got to.
It's going to work.
All the good that is.
And when you go in the grave and you're just laying there in the casket, the last hurrah, the final goodbye, what are you going to think about, Bill? Huh?
You tell me.
Well, that's the whole deal, man. You got to assert yourself, man, and think, I am here because. You ever think about that?
I am here because.
Hey man, you have 2 hours tomorrow from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. and be an extra in a film? Are you sure about that, Charlie? Hey, do you know where I live? I live 2 blocks from you. All right, dude, you got a pen? Can you get a pen? Yeah, I mean, you've seen a lot of movies, haven't you?
Yeah.
And you basically know how to frame shots?
I guess. No, not really.
But I mean, if you would see an action, you would kind of like centrifugally focus on it being in the center?
Yeah, I can figure that out, yeah.
And fuck it, man. I think my mom's going to have to end up going out in the woods. I mean, it's just one of those things.
I have my shot thing to do, and I have
This is the last day I can shoot. All of the extras have just fell through, man, except for Mike Shank right there, all right? Yes. You got to help me.
Mark, I had so much to do.
And I'm doomed.
What am I supposed to do?
Just stand there. Hey, Mike, make sure everyone has brown gloves.
Does everyone have brown gloves?
No, dude. You got...
I have some here.
Okay, yeah. Of the group of the Colvin, and then I got one shot, which is a close-up of me, and then one shot of a swish right to left of a tight of a Colvin member as he sees him for the first time. Yeah. Yeah, low angle, man. Gonna need somebody to scale a tree and get that snow off. Son of a fucking bitch, everybody just come up for a second, right up to the camera. I'm just gonna go wide on you. Yeah. Oh yeah. Okay, this is kind of great, but it doesn't. Okay, you got to spread apart like about 5 feet each. Yeah, that way. Okay, very cool.
Kenny, can you please put that soda on the tarp so it's not frozen when we're done? Because I'd like to drink it, please.
We're gonna do a 5-6-8 split then. Now you guys gotta look menacing. Can you be more menacing? Oh man, alright, well we gotta do what we can do then, I guess. Alright, I think it went pretty good, but I don't want to say that until I see the footage, man, because you never know what's gonna happen. I've been out here 5 fucking times now, man, doing the same shit. But I'll fucking get this down, man, and I think with these last 4 shots, man, we might have this fucker in the can. Cut, how's that, man? Talk to me.
Good.
Okay.
Yeah, well, we can't see your beard. How's that?
You can see part of
the mirror. Okay, this is the edge of the close-up, and then like...
Fuck it, you're right. Man, I go out here, just go out there, 2 hours, drive around these houses, man, and it's like, okay, now I know what I'm here for again, fine, and you got that squared away. But to be serious, The American dream stays with me each and every day, and I'm glad we're doing this today because I was really getting down and out, and thank God they extended my phone bill till Friday and lowered it too. But anyway, so today, man, I'm just going to go right back to work, man, so we can get... Actually, my house ain't going to look like this, man. It's going to be flatter, a lot flatter, less obnoxious than this.
He wants to have the good life eventually. He wants the big house and the nice car and all that, but at this point, you know, for the last, I don't know, I'd say maybe 10, 15 years, he's been delivering newspapers.
And then I realized one thing in a kind of a Christian-coded ethical arena, why should you be successful while others are not? Well, you know what? I got over that guilt, because you know what? Hey, I don't know that answer. I don't know why. It's, you know, it feels like in a Christian, what Jesus would be saying, it's totally unchristian, man, to try to get ahead. Because everyone's on an equal level playing field, an equal par. But you know what? I'm not a Christian. I'm half and half, man. Half's with the Satanist idea and half the Christian idea. Satanist, which is the pursuit of human endeavors, and Christianity, which is the pursuit of higher levels, you know?
Okay, part of the script is asking for a junkyard. There's actually several scenes.
This new girlfriend is slick. She's cool.
Yeah.
You know, and she's over, you know, what the hell?
How did you meet this girl, Mark?
Oh, she's helping on the film, man.
And if he's able to even do 25% of what he says, it is more than what most people accomplish. He's got a goal, and he's going after it one way or another, and he's going to achieve it.
Don't push me, you.
Why?
You fox.
I don't care.
You're not a fox.
Happy birthday, little Cece.
No. You are a chump.
Hey, what do you say?
Pee-pee.
Say hi, Daddy.
Hi, Daddy.
Happy birthday.
Well, Mark's got three kids by Alyssa. I don't know. From what Mark tells me, they never get along anymore, you know.
Alyssa shouldn't be, you know, shouldn't be worrying about what I'm doing. You know, I could just be having a fine time with Joan there.
There's, like, lots of connections when there's kids. And sometimes it's not broken off as quickly as it should be.
How do you feel about Joan?
Oh, man, I like her. Because, in fact, it's the one girl that I really respect and like because she's fun to be around. You know, and I don't want to mess that up. Bill, Hey man, how you doing?
Hi.
You're just sitting there, eh?
Uh-huh.
Hey, cheer up, man. The world is yours. What are you doing?
Just sitting.
What, contemplating what you did with your life?
Yeah, sort of.
What'd you do with your life?
Well, what didn't I do?
Well, what are your plans for the future?
It doesn't look like I got much plans.
I heard you're going to be a big-time movie producer.
Really?
Well, good news, Bill. We're working very hard. You'll have your $3,000 back very soon.
Really?
Yep. And we've got the whole tomorrow storyboarded out here.
I know. I saw that a couple of times already.
When did you see the storyboards?
Well, you gave it to me to peruse. So I did.
You perused them? Where are they?
It's in here.
How come every time I give you something, it ends up under the shoes or something?
Well, you told me to keep it here.
Within weeks, the film will be cut, finished, mixed, throw it an optical track on the release print, get it onto 3/4 inch, bump it down to 1/2 inch for multiple sales. What do you think about that?
Multiple sales to who?
To the buying audience. We're selling 3,000 units.
Who's the buying audience?
Bill, man, we're selling 3,000 units at $14.95 each, which is a return of $45,000. Pay for the damn film. Get the $3,000 back, pay everyone back, take the profits.
That'll be the day.
That'll be, and you know what? I'm going to bring over a bottle of wine, man. Do you have a preference?
That'll be the day.
Red or white wine? Red or white?